Okay, so first we'll talk about this search button. Okay, I'll inspect it. See, we are here. Let's try to find writer's xpath. Double slash input, because it's the tag name, input equal to at the rate. So we need to use at the rate, right, for the attribute values. At the rate name is equal to hint q, hint underscore q. I'm able to find it. Again, here you see value, it has no value. Like in English, it's called as oxymoron. Like different meaning. Name is different, but meaning is again getting different, right? Then if you want to write here and id, so we need to write at the rate id is equal to search input and operator. Now let's say you want to use contains here. So I'll write contains at the rate name comma hint underscore q. See this? So contains simply means, contains is a method which simply means that check that the attribute name value has hint q. So even though I do this, no, then also it will identify, right? Like if you see here, it's get, now I'm getting 3, right? So I have to do this to find it out. Hey, getting it? Hint underscore q. Now I can also use starts with, right? So it starts with hint, then I am able to find it. I can also use ends with, then I have to say underscore q, or is it, I want to show you xpath functions. There are at least 100 xpath functions basically which you can use and which you should know. Normally contains, text, starts with, ends with, give you the, it gives you everything. You see this number, abs, round, concatenate, substring, string length, uppercase. I mean, see contains, we just did contains. Starts with, ends with. Ends with sometimes works, sometimes doesn't work. It depends on what kind of XPath version you are using. So ends with I have seen, because in this case, if you see, ends with is not working somehow. So I'm using ends with. XPath versions you don't have to care about. Usually XPath 2.0 is what currently usually everyone uses. And when I say everyone, it's the browser's responsibility to use what XPath they want to use. So this browser perhaps is using XPath 2.0. But you don't have to worry too much about it. You have to just want to write XPath. Okay? Getting it? And few of these functions perhaps might not even work on HTML. They might work on XML only. So why I'm saying this is so that you don't get bewildered that it's not working. Because few of these functions might not work properly. But what works for sure is what I'm telling you. Contains, starts with, text, and few more. बहुत सारे इसमें होंगे जो चल मिलेंगे आपको चलते हैं हम getting it? सी कितने सारे पर आपको सारे नहीं करने. Okay. Now, before I move forward, let me also tell you what is XPath access. Now, this XPath access, you see these values? This simply means that you can identify an element based on its relatives. So, if someone is not able to find me, they should be able to find me based on my relative location in the document, in the sense based on my parents, my siblings, my child, based on that they could find me. Let's see an example. So just see what this is. Ancestor, ancestor of self, descendant, descendant of self, following, following sibling, namespace, parent, preceding, present sibling, self, right? Got it? Well, let's see an application for it. So I will go here. I'll write here, like simply @name is equal to hint queue. Mil gaya? Now let's say I want to locate this, and I'm assuming I don't have any unique property here. So I don't have title, I don't have class or anything, or type submit. I'm not able to find anything here, right? ठीक है? So now you tell me, how will I reach here? What is the right path to reach here? So I am here. So what is the relationship between this element and this element? I think this is like that chacha scenario I was talking about. Iska parent hai form, and form ka bhai hai shayad, right? Nahi, form ka beta hai, sibling hai. Getting it? Nahi samay. Okay. So this is your form. You want to go from here to here, right? Actually, this is brother hi hai iska, input ka hi bhai hai. You see this form? I've closed this. I'm opening this. This is its first child, second child, third child, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. Then a boy is born. Okay, getting it? So ye 5, 6, 7, 8 are input type. Then we have another button type. So is input ka sibling hai button. Okay, now we go back here. Which one I should be using? Right, I will be using following sibling. Okay, I want to know the next one, which is a following, but it is also my sibling. Okay, so agar main keval following use karunga to aage kafi aage ke bhi de dega mujhe wo following to bahut sare hain uske baad. Following means you have many, so button, input ye sare bahut sare hain, uske aage ke bhi bahut sare hain. Following sibling, I want to only know sibling, which is just following it. Main dalunga slash, then I'll write here following, right? Then I need to put two double colons. Okay, then I need to write tag name. Getting it? So now it is giving me how many? Two. One is this, second is this. Kyunki button type ke usko pure document mein bahut sare mil gaye, right? So I also want it should be a sibling, right? So I will do what? Following sibling. Now I am able to precisely locate it. So this element, which is this element which is currently highlighted, is a following sibling of this element. It could be little bit tricky in the beginning. Okay, so agar thoda ba samajh mein nahi aa raha hai to it's granted. Syntax, this is called as XPath access. XPath access, एक तो हमने methods अभी भी देखे, contains, text, these are called functions. Functions to be used inside predicate section, right? This is something different. This is something, functions exactly नहीं है ये, लेकिन something similar to what function does. It is used to locate the relative, कहना चाहिए, elements. So मैं यहाँ हूँ और मुझे वो ढूंढना है. So I will use this. Why we use this? Iska normal use case kya hai?
So finding kya karega? Sibling ko find
karega. So the original problem statement was I was here. Nahi, I was actually here. Right? Acha. For example, I wanted to click on this button. When I tried to find XPath for this, nothing was found. So no ID. I had nothing for it. Okay, or even it was not unique, it was changing, so I cannot rely on those properties. So what I did is I tried to find its relative, which is famous or which is unique. I checked for parent. Let's say parent also I couldn't find something which is unique. So I went here. And this is what I found as unique. So first I wrote XPath for this. This is, let's say, input. So that's why I wrote XPath for this. So this, when you see input at the rate name hint q is this. But this is not what I want. I want this. So what I did, after this XPath is found, I write following sibling. The immediately following a sibling is what I need. So I wrote following sibling, double quotes, and then the same syntax. Aapka uska naam, tag ka naam, and you can also put a predicate here actually. Agar aap predicate rakhna chahte ho, so you can write this as well. For example, yahan pe do button hote hain. Getting it? केवल एक ही चीज एडिशन हुआ है यहां पर. ओके, ओनली दिस इज बीइंग एडेड. गेटिंग इट? हाँ, क्या क्या होता है, समझा नहीं. वर्क मतलब एक्चुअल लाइव एनवायरमेंट में बहुत. इफ यू डोंट नो दिस यू आर डूम्ड, ट्रस्ट मी. एज आई सेड, व्हेन आई गेट डिस्ट्रेस कॉल्स, फ्यू डिस्ट्रेस कॉल्स आर ऑन दिस ऑल्सो. कि सर वो आइडेंटिफाई नहीं हो रहा है ऑब्जेक्ट. बिकॉज वॉट यू हैव लर्न सो फार और वॉट, लेट्स से प्रीवियसली आई डिडंट टेल देम दिस, और आपने ना कहा इतना इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है, समझ में नहीं आ रहा, छोड़ देते हैं, एंड लेफ्ट इट. सो यू सर आई नो XPath, बट यू डोंट नो XPath टू द फुलेस्ट. सो यू गो देयर, एलिमेंट इज नॉट एबल टू फाइंड, नॉट एबल, यू आर नॉट एबल टू फाइंड एलिमेंट. यू विल यूज टिपिकल नॉर्मल कन्वेंशनल अप्रोचेज ऑफ XPath, कि ये आईडी ले लिया, नेम ले लिया, उसमें कुछ कुछ कर रहे हैं, बट दैट इज नॉट इनफ. You need this. Sometimes you need this. Okay? So you, it's very imperative that you learn this. ठीक है ना? और ऐसा नहीं कि आपको इसकी जरूरत पड़ेगी तभी लगाओ, कहीं भी लगाओ ना इसको. आपको फॉर एग्जाम्पल एलिमेंट चाहिए, उसका सब आई डी वाई डी है, मत लो उसको, उसके बगल वाला को ढूंढो, उसके ऊपर वाला ढूंढो, एंड जस्ट सारे XPath में एक्सेसेस लगाओ. दैट इज विल बी अ गुड एक्सरसाइज फॉर यू टू लर्न XPath एक्सेसेस. राइट? सो यू हैव टू लर्न हाउ टू यूज ऑल ऑफ दिस. सो सबसे ज्यादा यूज इसमें फॉलोइंग सिबलिंग, सिबलिंग, प्रिसीडिंग सिबलिंग, एंसेस्टर बहुत यूज होता है. क्योंकि नॉर्मली आप पेरेंट को ढूंढोगे या उसके पेरेंट को ढूंढोगे, एंसेस्टर को ढूंढोगे, नहीं मिल रहा, देन यू गो टूवर्ड्स सिबलिंग. तो बहुत यूज केस है इसका. सो यू नीड टू लर्न दिस पीरियड. हाँ, तो इट्स अप टू यू टू सी, दिस इज हाउ क्रोम इज डिपिक्टिंग इट. ओके, एक्चुअल डॉम कैसा दिख रहा है? एक्चुअल तो ऐसा है, एक्चुअल तो ये है. अब इसमें आप ढूंढ लो कहाँ क्या चाहिए आपको. नहीं, ये तो सिंपल टाइम. अब यहाँ कैसे ढूंढोगे आप, राइट? तो क्रोम बोला कि चूंकि आपके बस की नहीं है ढूंढना, आप यहाँ से, मैं आपको एरो वगैरह दे रहा हूँ, तो एरो को कर आके आप देख सकते हो. सो मुझे कैसे पता चला वो क्या है, मैंने इसको छोटा किया, श्रिंक हो गया, दैट मीन्स दिस इज द प्राइमरी पेरेंट. मेरे दोनों, ये दोनों इसके अंदर है, राइट? देन मैंने इसको ओपन किया तो आई सॉ एक इनपुट 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 बटन. गेटिंग इट? सो यू नीड टू नो दिस ट्रावर्सिंग, कैसे जाना है. यू हैव टू जंप वन आफ्टर अनदर, जंप. वो ये चाचा भतीजे, फॉर एग्जांपल आपको यहां जाना होता है यहां से, राइट? सो क्या लिखते हैं, लेट्स ट्राई टू राइट इट हियर. ओके,